One man is out, and continuing now, the remaining luchadors here. Psychosis in there. Hector Garza there. You see Silver King and Super Kalo going at it.
And who is that beating on him?
The Vianos are
no,
in there.
No, who's this my man over here in the corner? Boy, this is hard one to call. Who is that
beating on him? Jr. That was...
Not the one without the mask. Right there.
El Dandy.
El Dandy's in there.
Yes, sir.
Oh, brother, let me tell you, somebody can take a seat. El Dandy.
Now, fans, much the same thing is going to... Oh, great maneuver by one of the Vianos. Much the same thing. Juventud Guerrero stuck in the corner with Viano number 5 there. Much the same thing is going to happen in World War III, although there's going to be a lot more. 60 and 3 separate rings.
Can you imagine the excitement around World War III only on pay-per-view? El Dandy has moved himself in a position now that he's in the corner, and he's not really getting hurt, and he's not flew out. For El Dandy to win this, they got a hit. I thought he had a chair on him there. That is a chair, isn't it, Tony?
If it's La Parca, it probably is a chair in there somewhere.
El Dandy now is putting his foot in the mouth of one of the luchadores.
Oh, boy. Great maneuver, and there's a fist to the face.
El Dandy has worked his way into the middle of the ring right now.
And Lismark Jr.
is staying out of trouble. El Dandy is staying out of trouble. And that's what he needs to do to win this thing.
You got yourself a favorite already, don't you?
Well, that's the only one that I know or recognize. You know?
Syncope in the midst of a tilt-the-world backbreaker that time, and a good move by
Silver King. That was a Lunar Colorado right off the top right there. That was a nice move. There's a lot going on right here, fans. Tony can bring it to you, I guarantee it. Pick a winner, you know what I mean? Just pick a winner.
Pick a winner. Oh, out goes Syncope.
Oh, he hit hard, too.
The last time we had a luchador Battle Royal was Monday, as you saw the footage on WCW Monday Nitro, and the Giant ended all of that. Cleared the house, so to speak.
Yeah, and went ahead and accepted, you know, gave him a rebuttal on what they were talking about when we talked about the NWO, and also said, he said this too, Tony. A lot of people might not have picked it up. He said, this is how you train for a Battle Royal.
That's right.
Cleaning house.
That's right.
And
that's
I guarantee you, man. And these guys right here, I imagine some of them will be in that 60-man. And this is a good training session for them. Plus, they get a big payday here tonight.
Well, give Psychosis, as you saw him almost go out, a lot of credit. Damian goes out as well. Give Psychosis a lot of credit. He wrestled earlier in this program. And he's back in there once again.
I'm going to tell you what, Dandy stuck himself in the corner there and is staying out of trouble. I guess if you're Dandy, as long as you ain't getting hit or staying out of trouble, you're okay to get down to the last few guys. Silver King is doing well.
Yes, he is, and Juventud Guerrero.
La Parca is doing well.
Yeah, La Parca, I tell you, La Parca, one of the biggest luchadors. There he kicked Silver King in the left of your screen in the face. Now we're over with Lismark Jr. and your favorite El Dandy.
Yeah, throw him out, El Dandy.
Dandy sent in Lismark. No, El Dandy.
All right.
Sends Lismark on the outside.
El Dandy's still in there.
And watch out to the right of your screen. Very close between Juventud Guerrero and Psychosis to go out here. But this continues, this Lucha Libre over-the-top rope battle royal.
Oh, I'm going to tell you.
2 weeks removed from the biggest battle royal in our sport at World War III. Both Piano, four and five, they both go out at the
same
time.
They can. They might as well go out together.
Hector Garza up on top. Silver King up there with a very dangerous.
Oh man. Boy, I'm going to tell you what.
Garza now hits the top, and he will kick Silver King all the way to the floor.
Springboard drop kick right off the top to the floor. And then El Dandy goes over and just wipes up the floor with him after Garza done that.
6 men remain in this Lucha Libre Battle Royal. And using Juventud, Psychosis sends the man crashing head first in. El Dandy and Hector Garza still
in. Hear that shot.
Kalo. Great double team that time. Kalo saw it coming.
Yeah, well.
Back body dropped the man out.
Yeah, El Dandy once again is sending people out right and left. Now he's got his problems with Kalo. We're getting it settled down now so we can see who all's in here. La Parca's still in there. El Dandy, of course, is still in there.
Psychosis, Juventud Guerrero.
Stay down, El Dandy. Lay down. You can't get thrown out if you're laying flat on the mat.
Into the midsection, but he elevates him to the top rope. Yeah. And he's trying to hold on.
Oh, he did it. El Dandy's still in it. El Dandy is still in his battle royal.
He only went to the apron. Kalo went to the floor. 4 men remain. Now the reversal. Into the ropes. Back body drop by
Stay down.
Juventud Guerrero. Up on top, thanks to Psychosis, but he holds onto the ropes nicely. El Dandy is out.
Oh, bless his heart.
Hey, hung in there, Dream.
Bless his heart.
He was one of the
final
four.
He did good. See, that just shows you. You never know who's going to be in there at the end. You know what I'm talking about.
We've got Psychosis. Give him credit. As I said earlier, he wrestled once before in this program. Psychosis La Parca against Juventud. And it's obvious that La Parca and Psychosis are teaming up on Juventud Guerrero here.
Yeah, and sure, Juventud goes out. And then they got to look at each other. Then you're going to see a change of attitude. El Dandy, come over here and watch this thing with me. Get over here by the monitor. Come here, get it. Where's he at?
He's walking away from me, Dream, as we go back to the ring here again. Juventud sent in. Ahura Karana has no purpose here at all.
None.
And then he gets kicked in the back of the head. Well, that's out of, that's just reaction.
Yeah, sure it is, because they in there and they're used to doing them things, going for the victory, getting to the pay winner. Different pay winner here tonight. To get there, you got to be the last man standing in the battle royal.
Would you think that the winner of this, of all the luchadors, would be the favorite of the Mexican wrestlers going into World War III?
You know, you got a good point there, but I believe anybody could have won this thing. It's like you said, sometimes it's not only timing, but it's being lucky. With that many guys, you've got to be lucky.
Oh, how about that? Psychosis inadvertently kicked La Parca as Juventud displayed his quickness and moved down. Oh, my goodness! Tried to boot him out of the ring, and he almost did. Almost shot him over the top.
Well, Juventud is outside right now. La Parca now moving in.
Yeah, he's not been eliminated.
Yeah, no, that's what I'm saying.
He actually went underneath the ropes to get to the floor, so I'm not so sure that Juventud realized there's another man still in there. La Parca has the chair.
Uh-oh. Now this will mess up a battle royal.
Oh, my! Both men go out! La Parca wins it.
That's one way to do it.
La Parca puts the chair.
What an exciting event.
And he is the winner of the Lucha Libre Battle Royal using the chair. And does a little dance for us as well. So La Parca is your winner. And we have more great action still to come on Saturday night. Stay with us.